Hello, my name is Sunny Daye. I'm also known as Kelly Summers. A few years ago, I was in a very dark place. I was a very talented singer who had lost a couple of opportunities of becoming very well known indeed. I had a very bad accident. I lost, in different ways, 4 out of 5 children. I put on a lot of weight. I was in a wheelchair for a year. I got reflux, which damaged my voice. And I was in a very, very bad place. Lost my money, my life, my homes, within 21 months, I'd lost my eldest son, Blake, and my youngest son, Cowell, in a different situation. My daughter and I decided to try and get through it, and when we formed a duo together, and Sasha went on to have a life, children of her own, I kind of became static. In 2005, I made it through to the Sharon Osbourne's boot camp on the X Factor. It was only 3 weeks after my son's death. I was in a very bad place. The footage must be very raw at that time. Following that time, I kind of plateaued out a little bit and had lots of operations, a forearm reconstruction. It was just a catalogue of disasters, really. Lost all my money, struggling to survive on my own. I eventually, in 2007, won compensation for my accident. And within 2 years, I'd lost £60,000 because the investment went bust and the money was lost and there was no way of getting it back. The little bit of money that was left over, I trained myself to learn how to use something called Final Cut, which was a tool for editing videos. I bought some cameras. I decided if I never went back to singing, at least I could earn a living. I was determined I wasn't going to go on benefits. People ask me how I got through. How do you get through? I don't know. I also put on a lot of weight. My weight soared up to 23.5 stone, just shy of 2 pounds off 23.5 stone. I was lost in a blob, not wanting to be seen, not being able to be heard, not being able to walk properly, not being able to function properly. I hadn't had a relationship I hadn't been in love for 20 years. I'd been bringing up my children as a single mum. I hadn't had a relationship with anybody for many, many years. Suddenly, I met someone. We were friends for 6 months. I thought he was the most wonderful thing. And I realised, for the first time in a long time, I was happy. I could be happy. I began to sing with him. And one day, he just walked away. Found out that he was with somebody else, and I began a video diary. I was at such a low ebb, the first time ever, I thought, I'm not going to survive any more loss, any more bereavement. And the Froglet Diaries was born. The Froglet Diaries became viral. I have 200 coming up for 6,000 people who follow those. It was done as a story in the Daily Mail. It went to America. It was on American TV. This pathetic English woman who had this huge breakdown for love. It wasn't quite as simple as that. I was never pathetic. I was devastated, but I was never pathetic. But I started these video blogs to encourage and empower myself to create the life I wanted. It wasn't about the first few blogs. If you only watch the first few blogs, I do look kind of deranged and pathetic look, like Phyllis Diller in drag. I had never spoken about the pain I was in and never allowed anybody to see behind my stage persona, Sunny Daye, for 30-something years. And all of a sudden, people were seeing me. What was happening inside was me going... I had a tumultuous couple of years. And the Froglet Diaries helped many people all over the world, and still do. People still contact me, Facebook, YouTube, how inspiring they find the journey. I began a new channel called The Phoenix Chapters when I finally managed to empower myself to end a very dysfunctional, codependent relationship with the Frog Prince. And you'd have to watch the Froglet Diaries to understand who the Frog Prince was. I became the phoenix who'd gone down to the ashes, burnt up, in flames, and learning to fly again. I have now lost, over 5-6 years, 9.5 stones in weight. I've got 3 and a bit to lose. My journey isn't ended yet. In fact, I feel as though I'm just beginning. In April of 2012, I will be 55 years old and I feel like a goddess. There's still life in the old girl yet. Not bad for a fat lass. I'm not a big wealthy celebrity. I'm somebody who has struggled. I'm struggling, but I am unbowed. I am never giving up. In 2011, in August, I actually got 4 yes votes and got through to the X Factor boot camp. Gary Barlow said, "You should have been a star years ago." And I thought, you know what? I know that. I know there's something special in me. Just let me perform. And of course, the way that the X Factor works, boot camp came and went. And people got through who we are dependent on humiliation, exploitation instead of talent. And I felt angry. I then went and auditioned for BBC's The Voice. I got through to the 3rd round of the filming and then told I wasn't going further. In December of 2011, I auditioned for Britain's Got Talent. And recently, in February, I was told that I hadn't got onto the live auditions. I feel furious because I know I have something special. I know I'm very talented. I know I can sing. I don't believe I have to be size 10, 12. I don't believe I have to be a joke. I don't believe I have to be young. I believe people should be able to decide who they want as their icons, celebrities, and stars. I believe that people like me have got stories that are inspiring. I'm never going to be defined as a victim by what I've been through. I feel I am somebody who is battling back against the tragedy, and I've got so much yet to give. I'm just beginning. I'm just ready to fly. So I decided to put an idea together of, on the back of the Froglet Diaries, because it went to America, and the Phoenix Chapters, I have opened a channel called It Should Have Been a Star, because Gary Barlow told me I should have been a star. And so what I'm doing right now is I'm filming my own web-based TV show with my cameras, with my editing experience. People are coming on board to give me their services free. I have special guests. I'm going to talk to my special guests. And I'm going to show you my life as I try and lose the rest of my weight. Look at me. Do I look nearly 55? Do I, heckers? Do I look as though I'm somebody who's a tragedian and a victim? No, I'm not. I loved my children. I loved my life. I loved my family. I'm a wonderful performer. There's something special about me. Let me show the world. God, flip me, Nick. Let me show the world. There is plenty of time for me to make my mark. And will the Simon Cowells and the programmes of this earth allow that? No, They want victim mentality. They want victim TV. They want people who are good TV. Well, you know, real people are good TV as well. We're good TV. I have people who will come be my chat show guest, be my TV show guest, sing their songs, who should have been a star also. And I'm going to find them and I'm going to film them and we're going to make something really magical happen. X Factor, people have the X Factor. Are they getting shown? No. Real talent is out there. I'm out there. I want to show it. My show, Should Have Been a Star, is going to be something special. Nobody has done something like I'm going to do. And I have 206,000 followers of the Froglet Diaries who are going to say, 2 years ago, this woman was on the floor, on her knees. She's got up off her knees, onto her feet. She's standing. She's looking damn good. Inside this woman, there is a goddess waiting to get out. And all I can say is, watch me fly, because I'm not finished yet. I hope you'll come on my journey. I hope you will be interested in me. But there's lots to do. And I've been in the recording studio, and I hope that you will be interested in my story, not just because it's inspiring from where I've come from, but because of where I'm going to go, and where I'm going to take it, and where I'm going to take some other people. I'm going to pay it forward. Look at the Froglet Diaries. Look from where I was. Look at the Phoenix chapters on YouTube. And Should Have Been a Star. The papers are going to be interested. The world's going to be interested. America's going to be interested. I am going to give Mr. Cowell a run for his money. Somehow, I'm going to kick ass. I'm not letting the story stop here. And whatever good I can do, I'm going to do. So take care. See you soon, I hope. And bye for now.